So in this video, we'll be learning how to make a Bedwars thumbnail. Other tutorials I've seen were more than 5 minutes and I just don't have that kind of time, so I'll be going really quick. Before this video starts, make sure you have Photoshop. If you don't have Photoshop, literally search up on YouTube how to get Photoshop for free and you'll find multiple great videos. Also make sure you have a client that can record Replay Mod because we will be using Replay Mod and also Forge Replay Mod. And preferably shaders as well because they make your thumbnail look nice. Once you have those installed, just join a random Hypixel Bedwars Solos game and start the replay mod recording. Then make a bed defense. And after you make that bed defense, all you have to do is sprint around. Don't jump, just sprint. Once you have your recording, go into replay mod and spectate that recording. Find a good angle with tons of player movement, and then press F2 to take the screenshot. Also make sure render name tags is not checked. This will make it so that name tags aren't in your screenshot. Once you have your screenshot taken, search up %appdata% in your Windows search bar. Then go to .minecraft, screenshots, and find your screenshot. Then open the Photoshop that you probably just installed, and drag that screenshot into Photoshop. First, go to the top and click on Image, Adjustments, Brightness and Contrast, and drag the slider up for both of them. Next, go to the same spot and click on Hue and Saturation instead. Drag the slider up for saturation as well. Then go to the left and click on the lasso tool. Select the polygonal option. Then press Ctrl and plus at the same time to zoom in and start outlining your player. Once you're done outlining your character, press Ctrl and J at the same time to turn the outline into a new layer. Then look at the layers tab and right click the newly created character layer. Click on blending options. Then check off outer glow. You can adjust this to however you desire or you can copy whatever is on the screen. Then go to drop shadow, check that as well. You may also adjust this to however you desire. Then press OK to save the changes to that layer. Then select the original layer in the layers tab. Go to the top and click on filter, hover over blur, and click on Gaussian blur. You may adjust this to however you desire, but I personally prefer a lower number. After that, go to the left again and find the rectangular outline tool. Select that and drag it on the original layer so there is an equal space between each of the sides. After that, press Ctrl and J at the same time to turn it into a new layer. Then select on the original layer in the Layers tab again. Go to the top where it says Image, hover over Adjustments, and click on Brightness and Contrast. Drag the brightness up a considerable amount. Click on the text tool on the left, find a decent font, and left click on the screen to add some text. Drag your text to the top layer. Then press Ctrl and T at the same time to adjust the size of your text. We will also change the color of the text by highlighting it and going to the color picker. You can also rotate your text after pressing Ctrl and T. After all of your hard work, you may finally export. Go to the top and find the file option. Click on the file option, hover over export, and click on export as. Over here, you can see the file size. If it is 2 megabytes or greater, make sure to switch the export format to JPEG, or else you won't be able to use the thumbnail on YouTube. Then export it to your desired location. Congratulations, you have just created a thumbnail for your next amazing YouTube video. Anyways, I hope you guys found this tutorial helpful. If you did, make sure to like and subscribe. It really helps out the channel. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.